Good day. A while back, I did my review and complete setup of the budget-friendly RadioMaster TX-12 transmitter. You can check out that video through a link in the video description below. As I mentioned in that video, I like the small form factor of the RadioMaster TX-12, the budget price point, and all the features it comes with, to include OpenTX.
Welcome to OpenTX.
A standard JR module bay for external modules like Crossfire. And it natively supports 7 different receiver protocols, including the popular FrSky, D8, and D16 protocols. The RadioMaster TX-12 even has 4 3-position switches, 2 sliders, and 2 momentary switches, switch A and D. Now this momentary switch on the right side I use to activate my quad's beeper. But I haven't really found a good use for this momentary switch on the left-hand side. So today I'm going to see if I can swap out this momentary switch A on the left side of my RadioMaster TX-12 with a 2-position switch so I can use it for arming my quad. Sound good? Then make sure to hit that thumbs up button below and subscribe to your TMAC FPV channel, your home for your journey to better FPV fun, flights, and racing stuff. The first thing we need to do is get inside the RadioMaster TX-12 by removing these 6 screws, the JR bay cover, disconnecting the battery, and removing the switch covers from switches E and F. These just pop right off. Then we see our momentary switch A is underneath this printed circuit board over here, which is actually no problem at all. To get to it, we just need to remove these small silver screws. Before we do anything else, I'm going to take a picture of what it looks like inside prior to doing anything so I can put it back together properly after I'm done. Now we can remove these screws and the connectors from the board and then gently slide it out from underneath this antenna cable. We'll need to remember when we put this board back into position to place it under this cable so we don't pinch the cable. Then we gently slide the board out from underneath this cable, remembering that this antenna cable is still attached. And we see our momentary switch is the small tactile push button switch, and it's activated by this plastic post attached to the push button cover you see here. This switch has 5 pins. You can see them better over here on this side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I want to replace this with a similar type of tactile push button switch so I can keep the same push button cover, that plastic cover on the front of the RadioMaster TX-12 that I currently have. However, it needs to be a latching type switch. So when I press it once, it stays in that position until I press it again. Unlike this momentary switch where you need to keep it depressed in order for it to be active. I wasn't able to find a latching tactile push button switch of the same size and type as this original momentary switch. The closest I was able to get is this 2-pin tactile switch that's a little bit bigger. I got 50 of these from Amazon for about 10 bucks, or about 20 cents a piece. So I'm going to be replacing the 5-pin switch with this 2-pin switch. And I'm hoping by connecting the top and bottom pin on the same side, or on the other side, top on one side, bottom on the other, that this switch will work in its place, since 2- and 4-pin switches normally act the same. The extra 2 pins are usually there for mounting convenience. So we need to disconnect this original momentary switch from its pads by desoldering the pins and then prying them up from the pads. Then once I've disconnected the momentary switch from its pad, I want to reconnect this latching tactile switch to the same pad. To do that, I'll solder these two pins to the upper right and lower left pins on the pad. I'll use some hot glue and maybe even some JB Weld clear weld to hold the switch in place on the pad. Because the pins of the switch don't align with the solder pads, I've decided to use short jumper wires to connect the solder pads and the pins on the switch. As you can see over here, I've got a short black wire right here connecting the solder pad, and I'm going to solder that up to the pin on the switch. I'll do the same thing on the other side. Next, since this latching switch is larger in height than the momentary switch which it replaces, I want to measure the total height of the latching switch as compared with the total height of the momentary switch. I'll use the height of the momentary switch on this other side over here. With that measurement, I should be able to determine how much of this plastic post on the push button that I've just removed from the shell I'll need to cut off from the button in order to accommodate the extra room necessary for this larger latching switch. It looks like the momentary switch is about 4.82 millimeters in height from the bottom of the board to the top of the push button. And the latching switch is about 10.62 millimeters in height from the bottom of the board to the top of the push button. So we take 10.62 minus the height of the momentary switch, and that's the amount of plastic that we'll need to cut off of this post to accommodate the extra room necessary for the larger latching switch. Before I cut this post, however, I notice it's at an angle. It's not perpendicular to the push button. So I'm going to make my cut at the same parallel angle or as closely as possible. This is probably the most difficult part of the switch replacement because I need to get the length of this post accurate enough to depress the two-position tactile switch. If I don't cut enough of this off, it's not going to have enough room to be pushed down. And if I cut off too much of this, it's not going to activate the switch. I'm going to give it my best shot, and I'll see if I need to make any adjustments to it later. I'm not really concerned about it because, as I mentioned earlier, I'm currently not using this switch for anything anyway. So the difference in height between the latching switch and the momentary switch is about 5.9 millimeters. So we need to cut off about 5.9 millimeters from the top of this plastic post, which brings it just above this leading edge on this side. But if we turn it around to the other side, it's almost flush with this edge over here. So I'm going to take my angled cutters and cut it at approximately the same angle that the post is at relative to this push button right about there. And now we're just left with a small post protrusion from the base of the push button. We just reinstall this button. It just sits in this hole of the transmitter shell with this little piece going over a little knob at the bottom of the shell. Like that. Now that I've cut this post, hopefully to the correct length, I just need to put everything back in place and try it out and see if it works. Okay, after I replaced the button back into its hole with that leftover button top glued onto the plastic post with JB Weld Clear Weld, I went ahead and reinserted the main board back into its original position, being careful to place the board underneath this antenna cable. Then I reconnected all of the switch and gimbal connectors per the picture that we took prior to disassembling it all to make sure that we've got everything back in its correct position. So now all I'm going to do is reinsert all of these silver screws back into the main board, put the back plate on, put the two switch covers on for E and F, and then reinstall the batteries and connect them up to the battery connector. Then we should be good to go. We've got one setting we need to change in the hardware configuration of our transmitter when we turn it on. So let me wrap things up here, and then we'll take a look at that setting and check out our new replacement switch, see if it works. All right, now we've got our old button back up. Let's turn her on.
Welcome to OpenTX.
Then we're going to go to our systems menu and page over to our hardware page. Now we're going to scroll down to switch A. And we're going to change switch A from toggle, which is the momentary switch, similar to D. We're going to change that to our new two position switch. And then we're going to go into our Aero 3 Hybrids model page, or model menu. And we're going to go to our mixes page. We're going to change our arming switch from switch E, this three position switch, which is overkill. I don't like using a three position switch for arming. We're going to now change that to switch A, our two position switch. So we're going to scroll down to channel 5, edit, change our arming switch from switch E to switch A. Exit out. And now let's take our Aero 3 hybrid outside, see if our new arming switch works. Our Radio Master TX12 switch mod seems to be working just fine. I like the two position switch a lot better than the momentary switch. Let me know what you think in the comments section below. Until then, thanks for your time. I'll see you next video. Clear skies, friend.